This video is sponsored by Manscaped. Check out Manscaped and get someone a better Christmas gift than just a lame bell like from the Polar Express. I hate the Polar Express. Now, the entire world loves this movie. They adore this movie, but I hate it. I am sick of it. I made a video 3 years ago expressing my distaste for this god-awful dog turd of a movie, but in that video, I was too nice. I was a young boy, a young kind lad. I did not know true anger or rage then. I was still pure, but now I say bad words. Now I stand up for my beliefs, and I believe that The Polar Express is the single worst Christmas movie ever made. The Polar Express genuinely sucks. This movie is a boring, dull crap stain on the entirety of Christmas. It's a lame, dull, and boring movie that features no Christmas joy, no Christmas spirit. The entire cast is played by Tom Hanks. Who the hell would ever even want that? Tom Hanks is literally a Simpsons character. I don't need him as Santa Claus either. Stay away from my Christmas, Tom Hanks, you weirdo. Now, if you fortunately don't know what Polar Express is, it's a movie about a train and Christmas that kidnaps a bunch of children and just brings them to the North Pole. And it's stupid. It makes no sense. It's a whole big train that pulls up in front of people's houses, and we just have to expect that parents don't hear the big train going honk honk outside. That's bullshit. And you're gonna tell me, oh, it's cause the kids are the ones that are believing, not the parents. I don't give a shit, it's a fucking train. And the entire movie is a train ride. A boring, dull train ride. It's a magic train, but the train somehow still has homeless people on it. Shouldn't magic repel homeless people? They're disgusting, and they're hanging out around children. Now I know what you're saying. Wow, Nick, this movie is pretty creepy. This is disgusting. I know, dude, it's so weird. When you think of Christmas, what do you think? You probably think of money, gifts, family, hot chocolate, sexy Grinches, mistletoe, and the sexy Grinch, kissing the Grinch. You know, classic Christmas stuff. But this movie is like, no, you think of bells. Bells, dude. Like, what? Bells? What? This movie has a weird obsession with bells and the sound of bells and getting bells for Christmas. What am I in debt to Tom Nook? I don't want to give him all my bells. This is supposed to be Christmas. I'm supposed to be happy, not bored. I'm not supposed to be sad that I got a metal bell for Christmas instead of a freaking PS5. Sure, there's a hot cocoa scene, which everyone always quotes and sings. It goes hot, 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 hot chocolate, hot, 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 hot chocolate. You know, it's the single only part of this movie that everyone always brings up, and yet, it's just not as good or as fun as you actually remember. It's a confusing sequence with ugly clones of people who just move disgustingly and anatomically incorrect. It's a terrifying piece of horror. Tom Hanks singing the lyrics screaming through your ear with his immeasurable amount of anger while children are drinking hot chocolate. It's terrifying. Maybe when I was a dumb child, this was cool. This scratched some itch in my brain. But as a smart person now, I know that this is truly not good. And if you like this, you are a dumb person. Let's start with the train, the express itself, the locomotive, the magic of the movie. It's a train that picks up kids, kidnaps them, and brings them to the North Pole. But it's a boring train. A truly terrifying and boring train. It has 1,000 train cars attached to it, and yet the only one habitable enough for children is this bland one. And the one all the way in the back for the delinquent criminal kids or whatever's going on back there. Why isn't there a magical, beautiful, whimsical train car or something in here? Why isn't each car some magical Christmas adventure? I'm not asking for Infinity Train levels of creativity here, because God knows that's peak train creativity. But why does this train have to be so insanely bland and boring and devoid of any personality? The only other train car we see is a terrifying puppet junk garbage one, which makes no sense. There's 3,000 dudes in the hot cocoa scene that just pop up and simply disappear. Where did they go? Where are they? Can't we see more life on this train from anyone? Why is it so dark and dull? There's two weird dudes at the front controlling the train, but they get about 3 minute scene. That's it. That's all we get of them. There's just nothing in this train. I genuinely think that this movie gets worse and worse each year, and it's not aging well at all. It's very, very boring and lacks almost any imaginative energy. The entire point of this movie is wonder, but the movie barely has any ideas to back up its wonder. Instead, it is mostly a lack of wonder with what feels like elements that just want to confuse the hell out of you. This is an ugly looking movie with animation that wants to disgust you rather than entertain you. The uncanny lifelike but not lifelike faces with the awkward mocap have left this movie to feel like what should only be watched with your eyes closed. It just has not aged well at all, and a lot of these children in this movie look terrifying. They are disgusting. I will hurt these children. I will kick them. But from any of this movie, it could make up for it if it weren't for the awful main character. I mean, his name is Hero Boy. Hero Boy. He has no name. No one here has a name. But this doesn't make them a vessel as characters or anything like that. No, they're just not characters. There's no one in this movie to care about. There's no one to care about or root for in this movie. All the kids are annoying and weird, and they're so weird that one of them even became one of the worst memes of 2020. 2018 with Sicko Mode Mo Bamba. Remember that? That was awful. Dude, I want to stab this kid. I want to stab this child. I think that's one of the main reasons I hate this movie so much, is because there's actually zero plot, zero story, zero character development or anything. The fact that none of these kids have name except this random billy-ass mofo is a bizarre choice. You could argue it's kind of deliberate to make this movie feel like a Christmas tale to stay the test of time and any kid could be put in their shoes. But I say no. No, screw that. There are no characters in this movie. All of Tom Hanks' characters are awful. The conductor, he's inconsistent. Sometimes he looks out for the kids and their safety and getting them to the North Pole. And sometimes he just doesn't care if they fall off the train and get crushed underneath the wheels. Sometimes he's very mean and sometimes he's very wise. He doesn't know what mood he wants to be in. He's not like the wholesome character that brings warmth to this Christmas with a stern personality. Instead, every time the kids want to know more about what's going on, he doesn't tell them a single thing, and he just leaves them to fester fear and anxiety in their little children minds. Like when he starts escorting the young girl across the train, Hero Boy is like, oh no, where is he going with her? What is he gonna do? Is he gonna literally throw her off the train and kill her? What is he gonna do? Why is he just taking her and not letting her say bye or a word to any of the other children? It's scary. There's the terrifying teleporting ghost hobo, who is supposed to be some kind of whack personification of the main kid's fears and doubts, but in what way? What way? This dude is just a weird creepy dude who flashes in for a scare. He has no good dialogue or anything. He's just weird. Go away. Santa, he's in this movie, but only at the very end to give this main kid a bell. Wow, I'm so impressed. Wow. Why is this man having an aura of God himself? He's just Santa Claus. What is this? He's supposed to be the lovable, fat, joyous dude, not Zeus Almighty ready to strike down non-believers. We spend like 30 minutes just staring at this big man who runs the Elf City. Don't look down on me, Santa. I'll kick your ass. Speaking of the ending, it's awful. The entire movie is just this anticipation for the North Pole. Like, OMG, I'm so excited for the North Pole. It's gonna be beautiful and magical. And when we get there, it's this empty, barren wasteland of a dark city. The excuse for this is that all the elves living there are in the middle of the city gathering for Santa. But honestly, that just feels like a very lame excuse to avoid world building and population. It would have been so much better, more magical and Christmas feeling if the elves were like frantically running around the city because it's Christmas time. But instead, we get the three mainish kids running around an empty tunnel system that feels more like a weird treasure hunt than a magical Christmas movie in the North Pole. The design of the city is actually interesting. I love the idea. I love the idea of the North Pole being this bustling city of Christmas joy, but it's executed in such a dull way. The kids exploring all the elf stuff and the gift sorting and everything is honestly ruined by its dreary atmosphere and gray color palette. Speaking of the elves as well, why are they all drunk smokers? Why does every single one of them sound like they're dying of bronchitis?
It's in good hands. Trust me.
I hate these guys. They're ugly and they make me never want to celebrate Christmas again. Basically, what I'm trying to say is there aren't any elements in this movie that give me the wonder of Christmas. If the whole point is to be a Santa believer and believe in the wonder of Christmas, where is the wonder? Where is it? It's not here. It's not in this movie. There isn't anything in here that works. There are far better Christmas movies, especially animated, that hold much more whimsy in their little pinkies in comparison to this movie's entire train. It's a bad time, and it's aged terribly. I liked this movie a little bit as a kid, but nowadays, I would rather avoid it every chance I get. But you know what you shouldn't avoid? Your personal hygiene, which you can maintain with today's sponsor, Manscaped. And thanks to Manscaped, Christmas came early this year because I got gifted a new performance package. Manscaped is a global brand designed for men's grooming and hygiene products. They have the best tools and solutions for the big man odor zones, your body, butt, and balls. They just launched their brand new Lawnmower 4.0, a waterproof electric trimmer that's of the gods. Now you can even get the ultimate Manscaped experience, the Performance Package 4.0. That's a whole 0.0 better than before. I can't tell you how much I actually love the new Performance Package, genuinely. It has everything I need to stay hygienic and properly groomed, leaving me looking and feeling fresh. The new Weed Whacker, the Crop Reviver, and the Ball Deodorant, it's just all so good for no reason. I'm telling you, living in Florida, especially, that Ball Deodorant is a gift from the gods, the balls gods, man. The Lawnmower 4.0 is a cordless trimmer that lets you tackle those areas wherever you want, since it's waterproof. Its skin-safe technology and built-in light lets you trim with confidence that you won't chop your balls off by accident. For a limited time, you can even get two free gifts, the Shed Travel Bag and the Manscaped Boxer Briefs, which are insanely comfy. So go to manscaped.com today and get 20% off and free international shipping when you use code 24frames, or click the link in the description. Trust me, your balls and body will thank you.